Krizlik's shot off Silverberg. Silverberg on a break. The shot saved by Hudobin, and Krizlik taps the puck to the board. Marchand holds. Back is in the bumper. Here's Chara's blast. He scores! Zdeno Chara on a bomb from out top, and Boston has a 1-0 lead. That's what we're talking about. That's the rhythm of the offensive zone. A couple of shifts in a row. They got beyond the power plays that Anaheim had. They started to find some rhythm, some legs, some puck possession. And even though they had two shots blocked from that left point position, the next two get through, and then the fourth one by Char is going to find the back of the net. Good screen in front by Bergeron, and they get the result they're looking for.
Chara's second goal of the season, is first in 23 games, and Austin Sarnik makes it two for the Bruins in a span of 13 seconds.
This has been a problem for Anaheim. They give up a goal, that confidence sags, and good teams take advantage of it, and they keep the pressure on. It's a play. Spooner from below the goal line. Just that little lateral move, and Sarnik finds open space. Bruins have scored a number of goals, Jack, by getting that puck below the goal line and then making plays somewhere between the dots into that slot area. And this time, it's Spooner to Sarnik.
Got it to it in time, but couldn't slide it in front for Kessler. Now he's got it behind the net. Silverberg drives the net, got a rebound, and he scores!
Well, there's a response, and there's a very well-used timeout by Randy Carlyle. 24 seconds after the Sarnik goal, the Ducks are on the board.
Get the feeling that this might be a little bit of a crazy game that we are going to see here tonight. Cogliano just throws it at Hudobin. Big fat rebound. And coming as the third man in on the play, it was Silverberg that started the cycle, got it behind, and he just went to the front of the net.
I think that's an old goal by Krejci, Brian. I think, let's take a look. Does Krejci score this?
Well, Silverberg comes down, he slaps at it. Oh, you know what? I think you're right. I don't know if it ever touches the stick. Yeah, and Silverberg points to Andrew
Cogliano.
It's going
to be Cogliano's goal. Pass across, deflected, as Botnin got a stick on it. Out of the box, Bieksa takes the long lead pass. He's in on a breakaway. Score! Kevin Bieksa! Just like they drew it up.
That looked easy for Bieksa. Boy, oh boy, he just snapped that five hole. A good alert heads up play by Getzlaf. This puck, Getzlaf lifts a stick, gets to the bounce, delivers a strike, and in goes Kevin Bieksa. And boy, he made his mind up to go five hole from the moment he got that puck on his stick. That was close to being offside too. I mean, he had to gain control of it because he was going backwards over the line.
Bruins are taking a look.
Well, they might protest this and ask to make sure that that was onside. Getzlaf as he tries to sneak down the boards.
And alone in front is Manson, set up by Silverberg, and he stays there and finishes the second time. So what a homecoming for Josh Manson, who played 3 years of college hockey here in Boston at Northeastern University, and he pots his first of the season.
Well, we saw a couple of occasions the opening period where the Bruins did not pick up Anaheim defenders. And boy, they get caught on this play. Look at Manson. He's just absolutely wide open. And that puck just chipped back to the front of the goal crease by Silverberg, and no one picks up Josh Manson. He just kind of hangs around there, comes right back to him. Chara can't prevent the puck from getting back to the front of the net. And it's a 2-foot goal for an Anaheim defenseman. That's a good
slides the puck over to Pastrnak, snaps it back to Krug. The wrist shot tipped in front, and Krejci pots it. The Bruins pull back into a tie with a power play goal. Last home power play goal was Backes' double tip against Tampa Bay the 27th of November.
And Backes was instrumental in his goal. And
he's to the side of the net in case Krug needs him for an outlet. And the minute he sees he's not needed, where does he go? He goes right to the top of the blue paint. He gets in the way of the shot. Doesn't allow Bernier an opportunity to control the rebound. And then when he battles for the loose puck, it goes off the tip of the blade of his stick right to David Krejci. Acts like a perfect pass.
Off the back of the net. Perfect carom to Corey Perry.
When Perry got it away in a hurry, there's a loose puck side of the net for Raquel, and he'll pot that easily. The point shot of Votnin hits something in front, And alone at the far post, number 67, the Ducks have the lead again.
Remember we showed you how aggressive Anton Khudobin was on the Silverberg opportunities? Here's what happens if you're a goaltender that plays above the top of the crease. If something happens to the puck, it makes it very difficult for you to get back into position. So that's a bad bounce. Good bounce for Anaheim. Comes right to the stick of Rickard Rakell, and that is a gimme goal for Rakell.
Bruins catch the Ducks on a change, stumbling in. Pastrnak going to save by Bernier. He was at the end of a shift. I don't know how much energy he had, and he lost an edge.